Good morning. I'm Eric Scott. Here's what you need to know as we start this Monday, November 16th. Some wicked winds and storms last night. Highest wind gusts, 60 to 63 miles an hour. That came in Harvey Cedars and Brick. There was a tornado warning issued about 8:30 last night in Bergen County as a storm developed near Fort Lee and Ridgefield. Too early to tell yet whether there was actually a twister that touched down there, but weather investigators will be on the scene later today. As the number of COVID cases in the Garden State reach record levels not seen since April, it seems more restrictions are inevitable. This weekend, Governor Murphy had a meeting with his counterparts from New York and Pennsylvania and Connecticut to talk about additional pandemic restrictions. The governor's office isn't commenting, but the governor is expected to announce new measures as early as this week. Is your place of work following the governor's new rules that require testing for all employees every day before coming to work, as well as customers who are coming into your building? The Murphy administration continues to urge you to report violators, and in just the first week of these new pandemic restrictions, people have certainly been doing that. Nearly 400 complaints were received by the state. Legislation advancing in Trenton would have the state take a more measured and regional approach to both closures and reopenings. Governor Murphy had previously rejected that idea, but now seems more receptive to it. Even though Murphy has announced he is not closing down schools, many districts are doing it themselves, moving to remote learning through the end of the year, many of them into the new year. South Brunswick, Plainfield, Morris, Glen Rock are moving to remote for some, if not all, of their schools. In Atlantic City, a number of teachers are refusing to go into school buildings. The teachers' union claims the ventilation is not adequate for the current safety measures. Among the temporary changes made during the pandemic was regarding telehealth. Insurers would have to reimburse doctors the same rate as if you were visiting them in their office. Insurers have been fighting this, but legislators are looking to make that a permanent change going forward, especially since there is no end in sight to the pandemic. We've not seen acts of disruption and violence following the election that many had warned of, but law enforcement officials and Homeland Security officials in the Garden State are ramping up enforcement and investigative efforts to make sure that it stays that way. For nearly a century, Atlantic cinema has entertained generations in Monmouth County. They will not hit that 100-year mark, the owner announcing they are the latest independent theater, this one in Atlantic Highlands, that will close for good. Now, the owner took to Facebook in an emotional post. Owner Fred Rass blamed the COVID restrictions, to be sure, but also what he termed greedy film companies, Netflix, and an unfriendly business climate in New Jersey. It was impacting his bottom line even before the pandemic. Got something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please remember to like and share this video. And we're always talking Jersey, taking your calls on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's what you need to know as we start this Monday, November 16th. Have a great day.